हेलो स्टूडेंट्स, टुडे आवर टॉपिक इज एक्टिविटी सीरीज ऑफ मेटल्स। दिस इज द एक्टिविटी सीरीज ऑफ मेटल्स, दैट इज डिफरेंट मेटल्स आर प्लेस्ड इन दिस सीरीज एंड यू कैन सी पोटेशियम, सोडियम, कैल्शियम, दीज मेटल्स आर प्लेस्ड एट द टॉप ऑफ द सीरीज, वेयर एज copper, mercury, silver, aurum, these are placed at the bottom of the series. And here all the metals are placed at the series except hydrogen. Though hydrogen is here non-metal, but this is placed in this series. Because in this series is formed according to the formation capability, positive ion formation capability of the metal ions, that is how easily the metal ions can form their positive ions. Here hydrogen, though it is non-metal, but hydrogen can form positive ion, that is from hydrogen we get H plus ion like other metals. So this is placed, and in this series this is taken as the standard. When any element that donates one electron, then there will be generation of the corresponding positive ion, and this release of electron, this process is called oxidation. So we can say that here the element A, say the A here is oxidized to A plus by releasing one electron. Then this electron is again accepted by another element, say B, and there will be formation of one anion B minus. So from B to B minus formation, this procedure is reduction. So here A gets oxidized and B gets reduced. Here A is called reducing agent, because by donating one electron, it can form one anion from the element B. That is, by donating one electron, it can reduce here B. So here A is reducing agent. And on the other hand, as here B is accepting the electron, as B itself gets reduced, so B indirectly, B helps to remove the electron from A. That is, B helps to oxidize A, so B is here oxidizing agent. So the element which itself get oxidized, that is called reducing agent, and the element which itself gets reduced, that is called oxidizing agent. Opposite term, A is here gets oxidized, so this is reducing agent, and B is here gets reduced, so B is oxidizing agents. Now come to the activity series. Here the metals which are placed at the upper position of the activity series, like potassium, sodium, calcium, etc., these metals can easily release electron from their outermost shell or valence shell, then they can form positive ions. That is, these metals can be oxidized easily. So if we move down this series from potassium to aurum, then ease of oxidation decreases. That is, their capability of forming positive ions decreases. That is, potassium can form potassium plus ions at very higher rate than copper or mercury. They form their corresponding positive ions. So the elements present at the top of the series that can be oxidized easily, whereas elements present at the lower portion of the series that can be reduced easily. So ease of oxidation decreases if we move down the group, or we can say electropositivity or electropositive character of the elements decreases if we move down from potassium to aurum, or we can say reducing power of the elements decreases. Potassium has very high reducing power, whereas copper, mercury, these have low reducing power. That is, potassium can reduce any element easily by releasing electron, whereas copper has very low reducing power. So these are the important properties along activity series, that is, ease of oxidation decreases, electropositivity decreases, and reducing power decreases. Now we will see different trends of these elements in different reaction. First of all, reaction with oxygen. When we want to react different metals with oxygen, then there will be formation of the corresponding oxide. When metal reacts with oxygen to form oxide, any metal, then the metal will be oxidized. As here exception of oxygen, and we know exception of oxygen, this procedure is oxidation. And we also know the metals which present at the top of the series, those metals will be oxidized easily. So the metals present at the top of the series, those will react with oxygen very easily. Sodium or potassium, they react with oxygen. When oxygen is has limited supply, then we will get sodium oxide. Here oxide remains as O2 minus ion, that is 2 unit negative charge on oxygen. This is called the oxide ion. But if we take oxygen in excess amount, then there will be formation of sodium superoxide, NaO2. Mind that this is Na2O, this is oxide, whereas NaO2 superoxide. Here the corresponding anion is O2 minus, that is, this is the mononegative charge, and here O2 minus. So this is the corresponding anion, this is called superoxide. In excess of oxygen we get superoxide, and all these reactions can be performed at room temperature or normal temperature. Similarly, calcium or magnesium can also react with oxygen at room temperature, and they form the corresponding oxide, calcium oxide or magnesium oxide. Aluminium can also react with oxygen at room temperature to form aluminium oxide, that is called also alumina. Aluminium oxide, this is also called alumina, another name. Zinc or lead, they will react with oxygen, but as they are zinc or lead, they are at the lower position in the activity series. Zinc or lead are in the lower position, so here their tendency to react with oxygen will be less. So we have to add here drastic condition, that is, we have to heat the mixture strongly. So at room temperature there will be no reaction. When we heat the mixture, then zinc will convert it to zinc oxide, or lead will convert it to lead oxide. Iron reacts with oxygen only in presence of heating to form the Fe3O4. This is called ferrosulfuric oxide. This is one type of iron oxide, and name is ferrosulfuric oxide. This is not the ferric oxide. Copper also reacts with oxygen in presence of strong heating to form cuprous oxide or cupric oxide. That is, copper in plus 1 state, here copper in plus 2 state, cupric, and this is cuprous. Silver or aurum, they are being at the lowest position or at the bottom of the activity series, they will not react with oxygen. So that is, they cannot be oxidized easily, so they cannot react with oxygen. So if we heat the mixture, then there will be no reaction. That is, their tendency to react with oxygen decreases along the activity series. Next, reaction with water. When these metals react with water, then there will be formation of the corresponding hydroxide or oxide, and there will be liberation of hydrogen from water. As here metal, from metal we get the oxide or hydroxide, that is addition of oxide to metal or hydroxide, that is negative ion. So metal here gets oxidized. So from metal we get hydroxide, this is the oxidation. And from the water, as here oxygen is removed, we get the hydrogen only. So this process is reduction. We know removal of oxygen, that is the reduction. So from water we get hydrogen. So this is the reduction procedure. Also, as the metals at the top of the activity series, they can be oxidized easily. So at the top, metals present at the top of the, at the upper position of activity series, they will react with water easily. So sodium or potassium, they react with water and form sodium hydroxide, and hydrogen is replaced from water. Also there will be generation of heat, very large amount of heat is generated here, and this large amount of heat, that is sufficient to ignite the hydrogen gas produced. So we will observe flame. For sodium we will observe golden flame, and for potassium we will observe lilac flame. So if you take one piece of sodium or potassium, you should never add sodium or potassium in cold water, because that leads to fire. Because sodium reacts with water, there will be production of hydrogen, and this hydrogen can be ignited by the amount of heat, large amount of heat. So there will be generation of flame. But calcium also reacts with hydrogen, but this reaction is not the vigorous reaction, this is less vigorous reaction. Here also formation of hydrogen and heat, but this heat is small amount. So this heat is not sufficient to ignite the hydrogen. So here we will observe no flame. For magnesium, it reacts very slowly with water, with cold water, as magnesium remains below calcium in activity series. Magnesium remains below calcium, so magnesium cannot react with cold water. The reaction is very slow. So we have to take here boiling water or hot water to react with magnesium. Then we also, there will be generation of hydrogen. Magnesium reacts with steam to produce magnesium oxide, and also there will be liberation of hydrogen. Now aluminium, for aluminium, zinc or iron, as they are in the at the lower position in electrochemical series, so for them more drastic condition is necessary. That is, here we have to take the water as the steam in steam form, but also with this we have to take these metals in red hot condition. That is, if these metals should be taken in hot condition, then only they will react with water to form the corresponding oxides and the hydrogen. For iron, we will get ferrosulfuric oxide. So we will observe that there is of reaction, or the tendency of reaction with hydrogen with water decreases if we move down the activity series. Now rate of corrosion. What is corrosion? Corrosion is the damage of metal surface when it is exposed to air or moist or any other substances surrounding it. This phenomena is called corrosion, that is damage of metal, and that the metal is said to corrode. This is called corrosion. So sodium or potassium, when exposed to moist air, in air we know there is oxygen, so from with this oxygen sodium or potassium reacts, and there will be formation of sodium oxide or potassium oxide. Again this sodium oxide reacts with the water that is present in moist air, that water vapor, and there will be formation of sodium hydroxide. And this sodium hydroxide again reacts with carbon dioxide that present in the air. We know in air beside oxygen there will be also carbon dioxide. So this sodium hydroxide reacts with carbon dioxide to form sodium carbonate and water. So the sodium or potassium metals finally convert it into sodium carbonate or the potassium carbonate. That is, the metal is converted to their carbonate salt. So the metal is here destroyed or damaged. This is called corrosion of sodium or potassium. Now, when aluminium or magnesium, these are exposed to moist air, then they also react with the oxygen present in air. There will be formation of white powder, that is the corresponding oxides, that is alumina or magnesium oxides, that is these metals also corrode. And in case of iron, when iron is exposed in moist air, then there will be formation of a brown powder form, brown soft powder form, that is called the rust. This is called rusting or rust, and rust is actually the iron oxide, hydrated iron oxide, that is ferric oxide, and there will be X number of water molecules. X is any integer, X number of water molecules as water of crystallization. So this is the hydrated iron oxide, this is called the rust. Maybe you have seen, when any iron rod or any substances made of iron is exposed to moist air for long time, you can observe rust on it, that is the brown powder form on it, that is rust, and rust is actually this hydrated iron oxide. So due to this rusting, damage of iron is occurred, and when this brown powder removed from the iron surface, then the inner surface again exposed to air and further rusting occurred. So this rusting procedure actually leads to different harmful phenomena like collapse of bridge or building, leakage of roof, etc. So this rusting is unwanted procedure. Similarly, when lead is allowed to react with, or lead is exposed to moist air, there will be formation of white deposition, white powder deposition on lead. This is the basic lead carbonate. This is called basic lead carbonate. It is actually a double salt, that means two salts are present. Within one salt, that is lead hydroxide and lead carbonate, these two salts are present as one salt, so this is called double salt. So this basic lead carbonate is formed, then lead is damaged, and we will observe white deposition on lead. Similarly, copper, when exposed to moist air, then there will be deposition of green deposition on copper, will observe. This is actually basic copper carbonate, copper hydroxide. Silver is exposed to air, polluted air, that is the air that is containing H2S, then black silver sulfide will be precipitated on silver, so blackening of silver takes place. That is the deposition of black silver sulfide on silver will be observed. So this is also the corrosion process. But whereas the if we expose aurum in air, that is the expose of aurum in air, there will be no reaction. So as aurum is at the bottom position of electro activity series, so they cannot react with air. So from here you can say that if we move down the series, then there will be decrease in their tendency in corrosion process. So corrosion process decreases if we move from the top of the electrochemical series towards the bottom of electrochemical series. As here is the corrosion process, there will be generation of the corresponding oxide, that is the metal is oxidized. So as we know, the oxidation, ease of oxidation decreases if we move down the series. So also the ease of corrosion decreases if we move down the series. So sodium or potassium can be easily corrode, whereas for copper or silver the corrosion is very slow, and for aurum also there will be no corrosion. Now to prevent rust, as rusting leads to harmful phenomena, so we have to prevent rust. To prevent rusting we have to use galvanization. What is galvanization? Galvanization is coating of zinc on sulfur, on iron. This is called galvanization, coating of zinc. That is, we have to coat the iron surface with zinc. As zinc is placed at the upper position than iron, so zinc will be oxidized easily than iron. So in presence of moist air, zinc will be oxidized rather than iron. Zinc will be oxidized to zinc oxide, thus iron can be prevented from rusting. So this is the prevention of rusting. We have to coat the iron surface with zinc. This is called galvanization. But if we want to enhance, but if some impurities are added to iron, these impurities means the some metals which are placed at the lower position than iron in electrochemical series, like copper. If copper is given as impurity in iron rod, this will enhance the rusting, because as here among iron and copper, iron can be oxidized easily, so iron will be oxidized and copper will help the oxidation of iron. So iron will be oxidized more rapidly, so there will be enhancement of iron. Here copper is added as if copper is added as impurity. Now replacement of hydrogen. If we use the metals which present at the upper position than hydrogen in activity series, they can replace hydrogen from dilute HCl or sulfuric acid. Because here zinc is placed at the upper position than hydrogen in activity series, so zinc can be easily oxidized. Zinc is oxidized by taking the negative ion, that is sulfate. Sulfate here the negative ion, and we know addition of negative ion, that is oxidation. So zinc is converted to zinc sulfate, this is oxidation, and from the sulfuric acid hydrogen is sulfate ion is removed, that is removal of negative ion, that is reduction. So sulfuric acid is reduced to hydrogen. So any metal which is placed above the hydrogen, that can remove hydrogen from sulfuric acid or HCl. Similarly, any metal which is present at the upper position than other metal, then this metal can remove the lower metal from its salt. For example, iron is placed at upper position than copper, so iron can be oxidized easily than copper, so iron can remove copper from its salts. Iron here is oxidized by taking this sulfate ion, this is the oxidation process, whereas copper sulfate here removes the sulfate ion, negative charge ion. So from copper sulfate we get copper, this is reduction process. So copper sulfate is reduced and iron is oxidized. So any metal, here iron is placed at the upper position than copper, so it can replace copper sulfate copper from copper sulfate. But if we want to perform the opposite reaction, that is reaction of copper with iron sulfate, here copper at lower position than iron sulfate, so copper cannot replace iron from iron sulfate. This reaction is not feasible. Now, reduction of metallic oxides. Metallic oxides can be reduced by different reducing agents like carbon, coke. This is called coke, free carbon or carbon monoxide or hydrogen. These are all reducing agents. When metal oxides react with these reducing agents, then from metal oxide we get the corresponding metal. So, from metal oxide we get metal, as here oxide is removed, so this is reduction, and here hydrogen is taking the oxygen. As oxygen is added to hydrogen, so this is oxidation. Thus, metal oxides can be reduced to metal. Copper oxide can be reduced by these reducing agents to the corresponding metal, whereas mercury, being at the bottom position of of activity series, so mercury oxide, when simply heated, then we get mercury. That is, this is also reduction, and here this reduction is very feasible. As the metals present at the lower position of activity series, they can be reduced easily. So, by simple heating, we here get the metal. So, if we take the different oxides, hydroxides, carbonates and nitrates of different metal, then what will be the is for potassium and sodium, their oxides are very stable, whereas the calcium, magnesium, aluminium oxides, they are also stable. For zinc oxide, the stability slightly decreases. That is, as we know, if we move down the series, their ease of oxidation decreases. That is, ease of reduction increases. So, zinc oxide can be reduced by only coke to zinc. Here this is the reduction, so reduction increases. Iron, lead, copper, they can be also reduced by any reducing agent. Like copper oxide, iron oxide or lead oxide can be reduced by copper or by hydrogen or by carbon monoxide to the corresponding metal. So, their ease of reduction increases, and for mercury and silver, they are placed at the bottom of the series, so they are highly prone to reduction, so they can be easily reduced only by simple heating. Here no reducing agent is even necessary, so by simple heating here we get the corresponding metal. Similarly, hydroxides, for potassium, sodium, their hydroxides are very stable. Calcium, magnesium, from calcium to copper, their hydroxides are, when heated, then there will be formation of the corresponding oxide and the water. So, metal oxide and water is formed. This is decomposition, sort of decomposition reaction. Now, for mercury and silver, as they are very prone to reduction, so when they are heated, then there will be reduction. From the metal hydroxide we get the corresponding metal. As here the negative ion hydroxide is removed, so this is reduction, so we get the corresponding metal, oxygen and water. Whereas for carbonate also, sodium and potassium carbonates are stable to heat, whereas from calcium to copper, if we heat this salts, there will be formation of the corresponding oxide and carbon dioxide evolution. This is sort of decomposition reaction. And for silver or mercury, as they are at the bottom of the series, they can be easily reduced. So, when silver carbonate or mercury carbonate are heated, then there will be reduction, and from silver carbonate we get the corresponding metallic silver, oxygen and carbon dioxide will be evolved. For For the nitrate salt or sodium potassium nitrate, when they are heated, then there will be formation. When they are heated, then there will be formation of potassium nitrite and oxygen gas evolution will be occurred. For calcium to copper, when their nitrates are heated, then there will be formation of the calcium oxide, nitrogen dioxide and oxygen. This is sort of decomposition reaction. So evolution of nitrogen dioxide and oxygen take place. Now for mercury and silver, as they are at the bottom position, they can be reduced easily. Here also, from silver nitrate, if we heat silver nitrate, we get silver, that is reduction here takes place. So we get the corresponding metal, that is ease of reduction increases if we move down the series, and utilizing this property we can say about different reaction trends of their oxides, hydroxides, carbonates and nitrates. Okay, thank you.